All right, guys, back to work tonight. Turn off the election news just for a couple minutes. We got to get ready for tomorrow's trading session. Big day coming tomorrow. It's Wednesday evening, after all. November the 4th, 2020. My name is Joseph, and as always, welcome back to your nightly newsletter. If you're tuning in for the first time tonight, it's great to have you with me because my job tonight is to help us find the best trade setups for tomorrow. That's Thursday, not just any Thursday, FOMC Thursday's trading session. I got a great video in store for you guys and gals tonight. Charts are all prepped up in the background. As you can see, lots of great setups we're watching for tomorrow, the day after the election. Got the S&P, of course, got the crude oil, and of course, we got the gold on our radar for tomorrow. Boy, expecting another busy day in the markets tomorrow. I've got a bunch of great trades I'm looking for in tomorrow morning's trading session. Before we jump in and put our hands together on these charts tonight, don't forget, if you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. That way you don't miss all the good stuff we publish every evening on this nightly newsletter. And don't forget, if you have any questions for me, drop those questions in the comment section below and I'll get them answered as soon as possible. And as always, if you tune in every evening, if you like this video as much as I enjoy making it for you guys, always appreciate you guys hitting that thumbs up here for me on the nightly newsletter video. So again, make sure you subscribe to our channel. We put these newsletters out every evening. I want to make sure you get notified, right? Drop those questions if you have any questions in the comment section, and thumbs up if you guys like the content here tonight. But enough of the introduction. Let's get this party going here. I know we're all running a little bit low on sleep tonight. At least I am right now. So we'll make sure we get this video done quickly here. Jumping to charts here for you guys tonight. Looking at charts here. Boy, where do I start? Over on the gold here, first of all. Right, gold's a nice, big, juicy, wide range setting up for tomorrow's trading session. Now, ranges are pretty simple, right? Buy low, sell high, but you'll notice it's a huge, right? It's a huge range, really wide range. I had to even kick up the time frame a little bit higher there on a 3,000 tick chart just to get the whole thing in there today. So a very wide range, and that is a really important clue as far as we go into tomorrow's trading session. I'll talk about how to trade a range, but more importantly, the most important things to keep in mind for a wide range, because momentum is a big part of this here tomorrow. Over on the crude oil, crude right in the middle here. Boy, oil trying to push through. We got a bunch of overhead resistance right now. The bulls are in control here on the oil, but they've got a little bit more job to do, right? Pendulum swing overhead, measured move overhead. I'd love to buy some pullbacks on oil, and I'm also watching for a breakout up to that big round number at 40 bucks a barrel. Got a couple good setups. Breakout patterns, failure patterns we're looking for on the oil tomorrow morning. And of course, how about the S&P? Boy, finishing that move up to that weekend gap, or that gap from a few weekends ago, right? October 23rd. And we're pretty much going sideways. It's a bull market into a trading range. We talked a lot about this plan in last night's newsletter. We're going to do a little bit more of that on the S&P tonight. So range-bound market on the E-minis. We're talking breakouts. We're talking failures. And of course, I'm going to put all this stuff together here in just a few moments. Got a bunch of trades we're looking for. Before we jump in, though, and get these trades ready, though, I want to make sure we check the calendar for tomorrow. Tomorrow, of course, is a Thursday morning. Now, unless you've been living under a rock, right, all week here, we know that yesterday was the U.S. presidential election. And as of right now, as of recording this this video right now at 5:30 Eastern time, it sounds like both sides have claimed victory, right? There appears to be some discrepancies, right? And the election is at this point said to be too close to call. Now, we'll obviously be listening in more important tonight and tomorrow. But that, of course, has really caused a lot of, not gridlock, but a lot of questions right in the markets here this morning. And of course, as we go into tomorrow. So tomorrow definitely will have a little bit of that tail end of, I would imagine, some indecisiveness, some confusion. So then we could see a little bit of a grindy session as we go into tomorrow's trading session. Looking closer at tomorrow's trading session, we, of course, have this two big news events tomorrow morning at the jobless claims at 8:30 Eastern time. And of course, the FOMC announcement at 2 o'clock, right, tomorrow afternoon. Those are the two big news events for us tomorrow. Jobless claims, of course, will get us started nice and early. But remember, anytime you have the FOMC announcement in the afternoon, you really got to be careful trading after 11 o'clock, 11:15, 11:30 on this Thursday morning. So be aware of that tomorrow. Again, with the presidential election, 2 o'clock close to call. And again, I think if you ask both sides of the campaigns, they would say, no, I won. So it sounds like there could be a little bit of a fight going on here in the next few days, few weeks, hopefully not few months, dare I say that. But hopefully we'll get some sort of clarity on this either way in the next couple days here. That will likely spill over right into tomorrow's trading session, right? We'll keep our eyes open for more. You know, it could be a bit of a jittery market tomorrow because of that, right? Might see some overnight moves here, but we'll work our way through it. We always do in our trade room. Tomorrow morning, 8:30 Eastern time, of course. 8:30 Eastern time, big news. And then again, get to it early because afternoon session tomorrow is going to be a bit tricky with that FOMC announcement. Now, they're probably not going to say anything tomorrow that we aren't prepared for. They're probably not going to surprise us tomorrow with that FOMC announcement. But, you know, who knows? We'll be listening in there closely tomorrow afternoon, and we'll see if we can update you guys here right tomorrow night. Now, of course, don't forget, tomorrow morning, the news tomorrow morning, jobless claims, 8:30 Eastern time. That's expected to be a pretty big news report. I'll be, of course, in the trade room tomorrow morning with all of our members. I would love to have you there right there with me. Come join me tomorrow morning, every morning, Monday through Friday, 8:00 Eastern time. I'll put the membership links you guys need to get registered right in the description of this YouTube video. So grab that link in the description, get registered, and come out and trade the day after the election with me tomorrow morning. All kidding aside, though, should be a pretty darn good day tomorrow morning in our trade room. Looking forward to some great volatility and some great setups. Now, we got one more big news event on Friday, too. We got the non-farm payroll number on Friday. We'll talk about the plan for that. Remember, for tomorrow, early in, early out, right? Remember, you got to have a good reason to be trading after 11:00, 11:15, 11:30 tomorrow with that FOMC announcement on the horizon. All right, let's get some charts all prepped up here. Now we know the big news here of the day for tomorrow, and we'll worry about the non-farm payroll number in tomorrow night's newsletter. S&P is ready. Oil is ready. Gold is ready. Let's jump into the S&P here first. S&P is very similar to what we were looking at in last night's newsletter. The key takeaway right now on the S&P is it's a bull market and it's into a trading range. Now, anytime we have a range-bound market, we always want to buy low, sell high at support and resistance levels up above the range. And we focus on failure patterns, as I mentioned last night, failure patterns, right? Failure patterns, seller failures below the range, buyer failures above the range. So range bond markets, they're balanced markets. The range acts, The range acts like a magnet. And so we look to buy low and sell high, and we focus on failures around the edges of the trading range. Now, because there's a bull bias on this, as you can probably assume, I'd rather be a buyer than be a seller. So when I have a bull bias like this, right, I start thinking, okay, I'm looking for seller failures below the range, right? That's the best way to kind of capitalize on a bull bias trading range. I can also look for breakouts as we go higher, right? And of course, remember from last night's newsletter, we talked about a couple breakout patterns that we'll look to be using, right? Remember these patterns from last night? If I get a bull market, right, into a trading range, what's the most important pattern to look for? Those failure patterns, right? Find a level of support below the range, right? And then look for a pullback. Look for those bears to come in to get short off the moving average. And once they do, right, you know exactly where their stops are. And when those bears get stopped out, what happens? The market will snap back up into that range because the range acts like a magnet. So bull market into a trading range, we're trying to buy below that trading range. There are two breakout patterns, if you recall, right? Two breakout patterns. One is called the 1-2-3 breakout, which is 1-2-3 legs. It's a strong pop-up. It's a pullback to the moving average and a strong jump off the moving average. If I can get that 1-2-3 breakout pattern, I can mark up the highs, I can mark up the low, and I could buy the low of that new hidden channel. As I always tell my clients, the first test is the best test off the low of that new hidden channel. The second breakout pattern is called a 2-try breakout. It's a strong move up, a shallow pullback, and a higher high in price We look for that trap below that low. We call these two try breakouts, right? So those are the three main patterns we're looking for here on the S&P. A little bit on the gold as well, but gold has a little bit more of a wrinkle in it because it is a much wider trading range. So failure patterns below, breakout patterns above. Now, when I go back to my chart, there's one very important clue that we can see on this chart right now, and that is that pendulum swing. You'll notice here, I've taken the size of that trading range, and I've measured the amount of the move above the range, and I've measured the move below the range. That gives me a nice support level down around that 34, we'll call it 34.25, right? 34.25, just to keep it, you know, the numbers simple. Now, what you want to think about here is as the market rolls lower, this is going to feel very bearish. This is just like we talked about in last night's newsletter. It's a range. But what we're getting right now is we're getting the market that popped up, and see how it's rolling over right now? It's definitely a bull market right now because we haven't broken free of the magnetic pull of that trading range. But the bottom line is, if I want to be a buyer right now, if I want to buy down inside this buy zone down here, I'm going to have to wait for a little bit more of a patient entry pattern. I call them nested failure patterns. And basically, as we go lower here, because the bears will definitely feel like they're in control, I'm going to let them try once. I'm going to let them try twice. I'll draw a trend line off of that low once and twice. And once I've got them trying twice, then I can look for that buy going back up into that trading range. Another variation of this pattern will look like this. We go down into that buy zone. We snap back. The sellers originally come in off the moving average. They jump up and we slam back lower and get a trap low here. This is one of my favorite ways to use what we call a nested failure pattern, right? It's called a nested failure because there's a failure inside of a failure, right? It's a seller failure. Second try, look for that trap low. So keep your eyes open for those setups tomorrow or in the early part, right, of the London into US session, right, tomorrow morning. Rolling over, bears try once, bears try twice. Can I draw a trend line and buy off that trend line? Or does it snap back up, right? Little tiny first try. They both have those two tries, right? There's a little bit of a nuance there you can see that you want to make sure you're ready for, right? Sometimes you'll get a nice, you know, sometimes it'll come down, it'll just roll over, right? One, two, and you'll get this beautiful, right, signal off of that trend line. Other times, that trend line won't be very easy to use. They'll be too steep. In that situation, you want to try to buy as low as you can go there. So again, a failure pattern, but in this case, because of momentum, I look for a little bit more of a patient failure. We call them nested failure patterns. Now, what about a breakout here? Well, first of all, if the market goes sideways, right, we want to stay out of the middle, right? Remember, the range is a magnet. So if the market sits here for a while, don't do anything. Just wait for that market to pop lower. Now, I will say, if we sit here for a while, if the market sits for a while and we kind of hang out here for a while, right? In other words, we don't just roll over and go lower. If we sit here and go sideways for a while, then I'll be able to be a little more aggressive on my entry. I'm still going to look for that pendulum swing. I'm still going to look for that move lower. But now I shouldn't need to be too patient on that because that momentum will kind of be squashed by going sideways. I'll be able to get long here as soon as those sellers commit off the pullback, right? So you want to make sure, again, I want to make sure I'm down inside this buy zone. If we do go sideways, let them try once to a short off the moving average, and I could buy right into those stop losses. So some food for thought there if we go sideways here. What's a breakout look like? Breakout pattern, right? Strong move up, pull back to the moving average, jump off the EMA. What do we call those? 1, 2, 3 breakouts, right? 1, 2, 3 breakout. Push the highs, push the lows, find that first test off the low of that channel. Now, sometimes you'll do is sometimes that hidden channel, depending on how steep it is, I'll widen it out by using the major low. You know, sometimes what happens is sometimes the 1, 2, 3 goes like this, and you're fine by looking for that, right, as your hidden channel, right? 1, 2, 3 breakout into hidden channel pullback. Sometimes though, these 1, 2, 3 breakouts that go like this, right? They're really, really steep. And so a lot of times in those situations, better off to use the anchor, the big anchor, find a little bit wider channel, right? And then use that channel to go from there. As you can see, there's always a little bit of nuance, right, for all of these patterns. One, two, three breakout pattern, just like failure patterns. There's always a little bit of a gray area there, right? So we'll definitely play it by ear, and we'll see what we get here for tomorrow. A two-try breakout, right? Last breakout pattern as we go higher is a two-try breakout. That'd be a strong move up. Now, you want to make sure you get a really strong move in a two-try breakout, right? Remember, on a one, two, three breakout, you really don't need that strong of a first leg, as long as that jump off the moving average is very strong. On a two-try breakout, you really got to see a strong move higher. Then, here's the magic is, a shallow pullback, it'll barely touch the moving average, and then look for that trap low, right, to get long, just below that low. The key is, get a lot of strength. Shallow pullback with a higher high confirms these bulls want this, right? The shallow pullback usually means buyers are not going to miss the opportunity to buy that trap because a lot of them won't be able to get in on that shallow pullback. Those are called two-try trap patterns. So again, range-bound market, we're talking failure patterns off the low, we're talking breakout patterns off the high, and you know, guys, I cover all of these patterns I'm talking about tonight, all the patterns I'm talking about, I cover all these in our free trading course. What I'll do is I'll put a link for you guys in the upper right-hand corner. Grab that link just popped up there. Get registered for our free trading classes. That way you can learn all my favorite setups. You'll learn about failures, including nested failures. You'll learn all about breakouts, trap patterns, and of course, my entire three-step trading strategy. So grab that link just popped up there in the upper right-hand corner. Get registered as a brand new member of our free trading classes. That way the next time we work together and I say nested failure or two-try trap, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. Now, the last thing we talked, what we haven't covered tonight is how do we get short on this market right now? Well, the hard part here is the market may be pulling back here, but that is a lot of bullish momentum right now. So we might, we're definitely pulling back here for the bears. And if we roll over, I do want to be patient for a nested failure, but I'll tell you right now, it's a little bit too early to call this a bear market. Now, there's a couple things we'll look for here, right, to call this a bear market. One would be if they can jump off this moving average and make a nice run lower, that is a 1-2-3 reversal. But remember, they've got to get a lot of strength coming off of that jump, right? A lot of strength. I'm not talking about something like this, right, that goes running lower like that. No, it's got to keep on going. It's going to be a very strong break to the downside. In that situation, I can mark up that low, I can mark up that high, and I can look for that first test off the high of that hidden channel. Now, where would they be going? Probably back to the range from yesterday, 33.64 half. Right? Remember, that's the pre-COVID high, right? That's kind of the prior all-time high before they locked us all down right a few months ago. So 33.64 half, easy, easy objective for those sellers. Now, at the same time, I would also say, too, that if we do stick inside this range for a while, right, if the market stays inside the range right now, and if we go up to retest that high, you can look for a crown reversal. Just remember, though, when you're trading reversal patterns, these are definitely not for small account traders, right? I would expect small account traders, relatively new traders, inexperienced traders, focus on going with the momentum. But you know, if you've earned it, right? If you've got a high winning percentage, I always tell my clients, once your winning percentages are 75, 80% going with the trend, going with momentum, then you can start adding on some counter trend trades like a crown reversal pattern off the high. Just remember though, the only way I want to trade this thing short would be if we spend a considerable amount of time right inside of that range here. If this market, if it just jumps up here like that, there's no way I want to stand in front of that freight train because we have all of that momentum right for the bulls already. So looking at possible a crown reversal, maybe it seems more likely though a 1-2-3 breakdown will probably be your best bet right here for those shorts. And again, don't forget all of these reversals, all the breakouts, right? All of them I talk about in that free trading course linked up in the upper right-hand corner. And don't forget tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock Eastern time, all the information you guys need to join as a new member, come out and join us in our trade room every morning is right in the description of this YouTube video. So grab that link or from the blog right now, grab that big button below this video tonight on the trading blog. All right. So S&P, kind of a review of last night, right? It was very, very similar to the plan we talked about and last night's newsletter. Let's grab a look at the oil here, though. Oil right smack in the middle. Now, you can definitely tell the buyers have control on oil right now. What's the most important key takeaway on this oil? The key takeaway from what I can tell here, if you can get rid of these measured moves here, the key takeaway here is we had a bull move up, right, into a trading range. Now, what do we do with a bull move up into a trading range? We look to buy into seller failure below the range, right? So you can see that is all working. That's all working fine, right? Buyers get long into stops of those sellers. You can also see too, here's the most important thing. Most important thing is look where we are. If I measure the distance we went below that trading range and put it up at the top of that range, look where we are. Yeah, we're right there. So, you know, I talk about ranges being magnets, right? Ranges are magnets. And there's kind of a magnetic field, right? Or magnetic pull that pulls the market back into that range. So as long as I am within that pendulum swing, I have to think there's going to be a bit of a pull, right, back down into that trading range. And that's important because you combine that with a measured move, as I had marked up earlier, and you can definitely see we are clearly bullish, but we're in a tough spot to buy right now. I either want to buy a pullback, right, at a lower price, or I get to see a breakout, right, going higher. I just don't feel comfortable right now buying into that pendulum swing, right, as it sits there overhead, because again, that rotation from that trading range. You could even go as far as to say we're not that far above, right, that high of day. Right, so there's a very, we're bullish, but a little bit tough to call this strong enough to buy a shallow pullback right now. I want to see a relatively deep pullback. Now, what is nice about this chart or this oil market is the strength of this last move. There is no doubt, right, those buyers have control. Very strong move. Remember, anytime we have a very strong move in one direction, we expect to see a follow-up leg. And usually that follow-up leg will test the high and potentially, right, continue for another measured move. So it wouldn't be far-fetched to think one leg, two leg, and then three legs up from there, right? So kind of think about that now if we can get that pullback. So, first of all, we're bullish. I want to be a buyer, right? Second of all, the trading range, right, there's my kind of measured move up there. And you can see that big round number looks like a really juicy target there, right, for those bulls. You can see I'm drawing that measured move out if we continue to go higher here. So how do we buy this market, right? We're bullish. I don't want to buy into resistance. I want to buy at support, right, ideally. And I want to make sure if we do go higher, I want to make sure we have some proof of this market really pushing through these highs here. Now, you'll notice I marked the range. And the range I'm actually using as the battle zone right now. I don't do that very often, do I? And why is a range a bad thing sometimes, right, and a good thing other times? It has a lot to do with rotation, right? Notice how the market came off that low, rotated, and look at the buyers. They came in, and look, they didn't try to run this thing back down again. This thing whipped running higher here. So chances are this market is just inches away from breaking out of this trading range. We're not quite there yet though, right? So I do want to be buying, and I'm going to use that range as a magnet. I'm going to use that range as a level of support, right? This 38.59 area, you know, give or take a couple ticks here and there. Looks like that's the range though. And so that's ideally where I'd like to be a buyer. Now there are really four, yeah, maybe five basic setups I'm watching for tomorrow. What I really hope that we get is I hope we can get a nice deep pullback down into that range, down into this little hidden channel that I have drawn off these lows. That's a really nice looking spot right there because you notice it lines up that low along with that range. You could also argue you're right around that kind of major top up there. So really like that spot down there. What I'd like to do is get this thing to pull back for me down to support, get those bears to come in, get them thinking this market has reversed. Once they sell short off the moving average, now their stops. Their stops are sitting ducks right now, and we can buy into those stop losses. More importantly, we can not only buy into stop losses, we can also buy that pullback before we get back up to retest that high. So keep that in mind, right? If we see a nice deep pullback, look for those sellers to get short, look for them to fail, and we can buy into stop losses. Then look to add more or take your first profit target and then grab another one on the pullback. Now, I will warn you, sometimes that pullback pattern doesn't pull back right away. Sometimes the pullback pattern will jump up, shallow pullback, higher high, look for a trap low. That's that two-try trap pattern I was talking about earlier, right? Seller failure into a two-try trap. Remember, it's all about getting in before you get back up to retest the high, because remember, with a very strong move higher, whenever we see a real strong move in one direction, we expect to see a retest, right, of that high. So make sure we're getting in before we get back up to retest that high. Now, of course, if we do go higher here, there's a couple things I want you guys to think about as we go higher here. The first one would be if this market grinds higher, right? It kind of has kind of grindy feel to it. You know what I mean? This is wedge I'm drawing up here. So sometimes these wedges, and crude oil is notorious for this, sometimes oil will kind of do what they call a melt up, right? And they'll keep on grinding. Now, if they keep grinding like that, and it may be steeper than this, you know, it might be something like this instead too. You know, it might be grinding like that. But let's just say, for example, the market keeps on pushing. It doesn't pull back very far. What this becomes a spike in channel. And anytime we have a spike in channel, what's the key to success? Buy a pullback or trade the base of that channel, right? So if the market kind of grinds higher here, melts higher, you got that $40 a barrel overhead. So if it does grind higher here, really stay patient, wait for that pullback. And these are some of my favorite setups because they almost always pull back right to the base of that channel. And sure enough, it usually will fool people into thinking this market has reversed, because it usually is a pretty sharp pullback, right? Sharp pullback, sellers fail, and buying back up in, right? Sharp pullback, sellers fail, and we're buying back up. And again, this could be a failure into a pullback combination, could be a failure into a two-try trap combination. You're trying to get in though before you get back up, right, to retest those highs. And again, those two-try trap patterns, I talk a lot about that stuff in our free trading class, right? So make sure you grab that with the links in the description of this YouTube video. All right, looking good. So that's one of the things I'm watching for if it grinds higher here. The next one, they can make our job really, really easy if this thing just takes a run for it, right? If it just makes a run for it, they can make our job really, really easy. Now, I can mark up that high, I can mark up that low, and we can look for the first test right off the low of that hidden channel, right? So if they really push through the pendulum swing, if they push through the, you know what I mean? If this thing really starts to push higher here, and you know, don't be surprised if it really jumps. Again, we've got this kind of the election results coming in here, right? Mark up the highs, mark up the lows, and we're buying that pullback. Now, buying that pullback here, that pullback, what I usually do is look for that same kind of failure into pullback combination setup right off of that low. Imagine the moving average coming over. So imagine this pattern, right off the low of that channel. We get below the moving average, seller failure pattern into a bullish pullback. Just gonna give you guys some more details on kind of the specifics of what I'd be looking for off the low of that hidden channel. Another pattern you definitely wanna keep an eye out for, because of the strength of this move and because that round number is such an easy magnet, we gotta go all the way almost to 41 and 42 from there. So $40 a barrel should be a relatively decent, right, target here overhead in the short term at least. If we can get a strong jump up, if we can see a shallow pullback, we're already very bullish. So strong jump up, shallow pullback, higher high in price. What do we call those? We call those two-try traps, right? Two-try traps. Bears try once, bears try twice. The reason why these two-try trap or trap patterns work so well is because the strong move up creates a sense of FOMO. The shallow pullback doesn't give buyers a chance to buy where they really want to. And so once it does pull back a little bit deeper, those same buyers are not going to make the mistake again. They're gonna throw the kitchen sink at it and make sure they're getting in on that trap. So definitely a couple breakout patterns that you want to think about. Nothing different here, right? 1, 2, 3 breakouts, 2-try breakouts on the way up to that big round number. And if they keep this thing going tomorrow, you get that 41. It literally goes 40, 41, and then pretty much 42. There's these wide open spaces here. if you look at some of the bigger term time frames here. So got a pretty good plan there as that market goes higher here. The only thing I would be kind of watching for is you can almost kind of see this might be a little bit of a range forming here. So if we do go sideways here into a range, what do? We buy low and we buy the breakout, right? So we've talked about that quite a bit already. We wait for that pullback. We wait for that seller failure. If we have enough space, we can look for that failure into pullback combination, right? Again, buying at support levels below that trading range, failure into pullback combination, or we get that breakout, right? 1, 2, 3 breakout. Remember, this of course is assuming the market goes sideways here, right? Overnight, 1, 2, 3 breakout, right? Or 2 try breakout, right? 2 try trap pattern right there as we go higher. So kind of really, I think a pretty straightforward plan here on this crude oil. How do we get short this market right now? Can I sell this thing? Not if you like the money in your account to get bigger, not smaller. Very strong move higher. Anytime we have this much strength going higher here, I don't care if there's a range back here. There's too much strength. What I've learned over the years is don't fight the strength, right? Don't fight the strength. Anytime we see a strong move, be ready for that pullback and that next leg higher. Strong move, be ready for that pullback and that next leg higher. What I made the mistake a lot when I was a new trader is I would see a sharp pullback. I would confuse that for a reversal. I'd be kind of roped into getting short, and you know the odds are not very good, right? The odds are better. We go back to retest the high. We don't want to make that mistake. So if they do get that strong run down and we can get that pullback to the moving average and jump off the EMA, yeah, now we're talking. Now there's a big bullseye right on that low from today, 37.26. Mark that low, mark that high. First test is the best test, right off of that high. And again, I'm talking about selling the first test of the high of that hidden channel. Think about it this way. Think about the pattern as, right, a buyer failure into a bearish pullback, right? Kind of imagine now, right, how that moving average will come over here. That's typically the way that pattern will set up. And remember, guys, we're going to do all this together tomorrow morning in the trade room. So we're going over the basics right now. I cover all these setups again in that free trading course, which is linked up in the upper right-hand corner. And you can register for the trade room tomorrow morning by joining as a member. The link's in the description of this YouTube video. All right, we're looking good. So now we've got the reversal that we need here, right? 1, 2, 3 reversal, strong move down, hold that pullback. Remember, jump off the moving average, right? None of this little jump here and come, yeah, that's going to come right back up again. Jump off the moving average, show me some strength, then mark the low, mark the high, and we'll short right off that high. All right, guys, and again, we'll pick up where we left off tomorrow morning in our trade room. Crude oil, you're looking good here, crude. I like what we're looking for here tomorrow. How about some gold? Now, remember, gold, really, this whole week is going to be a little bit difficult on gold. You got the FOMC tomorrow. You got non-farms on Friday. And again, the never-ending election right now, the election that's been going on for over 4 years now, pretty much, right? So you've got the election results still trickling in. That will likely be an impact player on gold tomorrow. You've also, of course, right, got the FOMC announcement tomorrow afternoon. If there's one market tomorrow that is probably going to be the most difficult, this will probably be it right in front of you. So be careful tomorrow if the price action is feeling a bit squirrely, as we always say, right? Just go easy on it. You know, tomorrow is definitely not the day to be increasing position sizes or testing out new strategies on live trade accounts, right? Tomorrow is a day to do what works well and do it well, right? Keep your position size small, keep the risk small. There'll be plenty more opportunities, right, to come on gold. FOMC days are always a bit of a tricky day because it's a monetary policy decision right in the afternoon, and gold, you'll see a lot of positioning right ahead of that news report tomorrow. So please be careful on the gold. And again, as I mentioned in last night's newsletter, make sure you get with your broker so you know what margins look like right now, overnight margins, intraday margins, because they have been increasing during this election week. So what's the key takeaway right now on the gold? Well, I think we can all probably see we're range, right? We're overall bullish, I will say. Right, we're bullish into that trading range. So we know that in a range bound market, right, the range itself, if you recall, the range itself acts as a magnet, right? Range acts as a magnet. So I do want to be a buyer, right? Below that range. I can also be a buyer with some breakout patterns, right? As we go higher here. There's one more, there's like two more clues here though. One clue is the strong move down. Now, I have learned over the years that anytime I see a strong shot at the beginning of the session like this, don't forget about it, because there's a big bullseye down here around that 81.8 for these bears. The bears would love, because look, they haven't taken the highs out yet. So you could basically say that gold went running lower, has pulled all the way back now, and remember, anytime we see a strong move in one direction, they're going to try to retest that low, try to take out, right, those sellers down there, right? So we're expecting to see this run, right? I would expect to see some sort of movement down, right, to retest that low. So keep that in the back of your, you know, keep that in the back of your mind here. The third clue is possibly the most important clue, and it's the width of this trading range. This is not just some skinny range, right? This is a big, nice range here. You'll notice this is a 3,000 tick chart, a little bit slower, right, than we normally use here. I'm usually around a 1,500 or a 2,000 tick chart on gold. A lot of volume, a lot of movement. Now, why does it matter, right? Isn't a range a range? It is, but remember, the wider the range is, the more momentum can come into play. All right, that's the most important thing you want to remember here. So the principles are the same, right? The range is a magnet. Whatever goes down should come back up. I would expect them to take out these lows at some point tomorrow. That's where I would expect some of the best buy setups will probably be tomorrow, just below that 81.8. Take out those lows, right? At the same time, though, resistance here overhead, what goes up will likely come back down, but there's an overall bull bias to it, right? So trying to sell short off the high will definitely be a little bit tricky, right? So here's the problem. The fundamentals are still very strong with the range, but the width of the range means momentum becomes a problem. So for example, if we make a run back lower here, right, I gotta be very careful, because if I try to step in front, right, of that freight train, a lot of times you'll get trapped, right, and you'll get run out of that trade. So whenever I have a wide range like this, I always look for kind of one of these two scenarios. The first one I look for is a one try down. Let the bears finish off that retest, and then look for the failure into the pullback back up from there. So again, imagine, right, we make a run lower. That's going to be a very strong move down. And anytime we see a strong move down, right, you want to expect another leg in the same direction. Well, once they get that second leg down, now we've got the sellers that have pretty much completed all their objectives. They finished off the retest low, they ran lower and retested that, right? They kind of got it all out of their system, if you will. Once I have those bears running down and completing that retest, and that could also be where we get a breakout of this trading range, but assume now we just complete that retest, what happens now is now as we come over, I can look for, and again, the bears got what they wanted, now we can go back up into that trading range. Watch for the sellers to fail off the moving average, watch for that breakout into pullback combination, or that failure into pullback combination. Now remember, please don't confuse this with a strong move down and a seller failure back up. It's not the same pattern. It's a strong move down. The size of that move, because the range is so wide, allows for that momentum to come over. Then I can go out now, and now I can look for that one, right? Look for those sellers to get short, buy into stops, buy the pullback off the moving average. And where's my target? My target would be right back around that 1901, and if you got an extra contract on it, right, leave the runner back to the other side of that trading range. Now, one more kind of variable of this I want to bring to your attention too would be if we do see just a straight nested failure. For example, sometimes we'll see it market run lower, they'll pull back, right? They'll try to run once, they'll pull back, they'll try to run twice. That will work. The most important thing you want to think about tomorrow, though, is you got to let them try twice, two relatively big tries. I'm not going to be looking for that one, that two, right? That's not what I'm looking for. Because that momentum is so strong, I'm going to want to see, as this thing pulls back here, show me one try for the bears, pull it up. And again, I like to draw that trend line off of that low. The key here is there should be significant separation between these two tries, right? They're not going to be strong move down, then one, two, and then right back up. They might, but that won't be the most reliable setup you can look for. What I want is I want to see these bears try once, and I want to give them the benefit of the doubt. Let them try twice. If I can find that trend line to buy off support, another variation of that would be as we go lower here, right? Bears try once, we go higher. Again, big time separation between these two. Because why? Momentum. Momentum is a big concern when ranges are very wide like this. So again, it's either strong move down and complete the retest, then the reversal back up, then the failure back up, or it's strong move down, bears try once, big space, bears try twice, trap low. That's a great setup, but it takes a little bit longer, right, than you think it will, right? It usually will take a little bit longer than you think it will. That's going to be the key to our success tomorrow, right, as it goes lower. Is going to be that again, that kind of nested, right, that nested failure, right, off of that low. Now, as we go higher here, okay, the hard part, right, the hard part about trying to sell off this high is that we have all of that bullishness, right? So as we go higher here, again, we know avoid the middle, stay out of that middle. We don't want to do anything in the middle here. Wait for that nested failure at the lows. As it runs higher here, what are some options? Breakouts. We can easily use the same momentum problem we have for the bears or for the bulls. Is a momentum, it's a resource, it's an asset for us here to be a buyer. So strong move up, if the buyers have this momentum on their side, they should be able to hold that pullback and go. Now, we haven't seen them hold the pullback yet, right? They haven't held the pullback yet. So if they can get a 1, 2, 3 break higher, bingo. Mark that high, mark that low. We can buy the low, right? Buy the low of that new hidden channel, right? Where's my target, by the way, up top here? Next target is 1939.5. 1939.5 is our next big objective here overhead. So again, typical breakout patterns. 1, 2, 3 breakout. Remember, strong jump off the moving average, mark the high, mark the low, buy that first test of the low of that channel, or it's a very strong move. Remember, that's the key to this two-type trap. Big, strong move, shallow pullback teases the buyers, and they don't miss it on the trap, right? Those are the two breakout patterns, right, as we go higher here. Overall bullish trend. So I can be relatively aggressive if we can get some momentum going, right, on our side here. And again, we'll use that same momentum here, right? That same, again, the same size of this range that helps the bulls right now, right? It's going to hurt the bulls if it comes back down here, right, around those lows. All right, guys, stay out of the middle. Focus on buying nice and low, selling nice and high. In this case, though, again, because we're so bullish right now, right, we're focused on buying low or buying those bull breakouts. What would it take to be a bear in this market right now? It would take a small miracle, it feels like, right now. But a lot of buyers are going to be waiting down here, right? So we'd have to see a strong move down. They have to hold that pullback, and they've got to really jump, right? Really jump. There has to be enough momentum coming off that moving average where there's no doubt about we're running down to that 1859 area. Mark that low, mark that high, right, and go and get short off that high. Again, I'm not trying to sell the first pullback. It's just not a reliable place to be selling below the low of that trading range. 1859, 1851 are the levels looking for here to the downside. So quite an open space here if we can get some momentum going here on the gold. The big question tomorrow is how much of this election chaos will affect us tomorrow? How much will the FOMC announcement affect us tomorrow morning? Remember, tomorrow for noon is pretty much said and done because you got the FOMC announcement at 2:00. Tomorrow morning, that's where the good stuff is. That's what the meat and potatoes are going to be here for tomorrow. Will the election, recounting and final tallies, will that interrupt it? Will the market be waiting on those election results? Only, right? No, nobody knows for sure right now, but one thing I do know is no matter what we get tomorrow, we're going to trade our plan. We'll plan our trades, and we'll trade our plan tomorrow morning. I would love to have you right there with me tomorrow morning, guys, 8:00 Eastern time. We do this together every morning. I'll put a big link for you guys. I'll put a link for you guys to get registered for tomorrow morning's trade room session. Grab that link in the description. Come out and join me tomorrow morning and every morning, Monday through Friday, at the opening bell, right? We'll plan our trades, we'll trade our plan, and we'll do it all together. All right, guys, don't forget to call the office if you have any questions. Call that toll-free phone number. Use that live support on the right-hand side. Drop me some questions in the comment section if you guys have any questions. And I hope by now I've earned a subscribe, at least a thumbs up. Now, go get some sleep. I know we're all probably delirious at this point in the day. So get some sleep. I know I'm trying to stay up too late tonight here because we got a lot of work to do tomorrow morning in our trade room. That's all for me tonight, guys. Have a great rest of your evening out there. Turn off the television. Get some sleep. And we'll see you guys tomorrow morning at the opening bell. As always, my name is Joseph. Be well out there. Be nice to each other, will ya? And be here next time. Adios, amigos. Bye-bye for now.